Afilu rekarim shabacha meleya mitzvahs kirimen. Every single yid, even the emptiest of a yid, is filled with mitzvahs like a pomegranate is filled with seeds. And as the Rebbe explains, a pomegranate is filled with seeds. What is a pomegranate? It is its seeds. When you buy a pomegranate, it's not, oh, so what do I have here? Look, I bought some shell. I'll take a look, there's also some seeds. No, the whole pomegranate is the seeds. That's why you're buying it, that's the ikar of it. Says the Gemara, that afilu rekanan shebecha, even the most emptiest of yidin, melei mitzvahs kirimen, what are they really? They're the mitzvahs, they're the seeds, they're the... There's a story about someone who once came to the Rebbe. He wasn't a Lubavitcher, he was another chassid, and of another chassidus. And when he came in, the Rebbe asked him, he says, that your Rebbe, he recently had a yahrzeit, so there was a yahrzeit, just tell me a pesavart that the Rebbe said. So he told the Rebbe that his Rebbe made a seam on a sechtas chagiga, and when he got to these words, that afilu rekanan shebecha malein mitzvahs kerima, and even the emptiest of Yidden are filled with mitzvahs like a pomegranate. So the Rebbe said, this other Rebbe said, I don't understand that if they're so rekanan, if they're so empty, how do we say in them that they're filled with mitzvahs like a demon? And the Rebbe said, I also don't understand the Gemara, but my question is the opposite way around. If they're malein mitzvahs kerima, if they're filled with mitzvahs like a pomegranate, how do we call them rekanan? How do we call them empty? Mm-hmm. There's a person that once came to the Rebbe. There's a video of this. And he told the Rebbe that I have a brother who has no shaykhus to Yiddishkeit. And he asked for a bracha for his brother. And the Rebbe looked at him and the Rebbe says, he has no shaykhus to Yiddishkeit? He is a Yid. What do you mean he has no shaykhus to Yiddishkeit? That's who he is. That's what he is. Your job, as his brother, the Rebbe says, is to try to reveal that. To say that a Yid has no shaykhus to Yiddishkeit, what does that mean? Yiddishkeit is not something that we can have a shaykhus to or not. It's what we are. Va'am echulum sadikim. It's because at the inside of us. And when we have this perspective about ourselves, the whole tshuva is another tshuva. The question isn't how I'm going to change. You want to know what the real question is? The real question is, how did I ever do an avera? The Zohar, the pasuk nefesh kisechta, the Zohar says nefesh kisechta, a yid does an avera, tivaha. That doesn't make sense. Something doesn't compute, the Zohar says. How does a yid do an avera? How does a yid with an neshama, a yid who's a chelik alekami mal mamish, a yid who is willing to be meiser nefesh al kedushas Hashem, he'd give up his life for Yiddishkeit, how does he do something so silly as an avera? That doesn't make sense. So what's pshat? How does a yid do an avera? So the Gemara says, ein adamei v'avera, elim kei nichnas beiroshtus. That means that when a yid does an avera, he's not himself. He's insane. So if we're doing tshuva, we're not looking to change. We are looking to go deeper into ourselves and to find the real, true me. The true me who wants to connect to Hashem, who's a tzaddik, who the Rambam says that every single yid, kol echad v'echad miyisrael, reitzel yis miyisrael, wants to be a yid, and reitzel lasis kol ha-mitzvah, wants to do every mitzvah, v'reitzel yisrachik min averes, every yid. Even the yid who's standing, the Rambam says, and standing and screaming, I don't want to. You should know he's lying. This is the halacha, it's not Tanya. He's lying. He wants to do mitzvahs. He doesn't want to do an avera. And his yitzhahara got a little hold of him. He's being insane at the moment. And when we have that perspective, it all changes. I'm not trying, it's not that I'm a bad person trying to change to a good person. That's very difficult. I'm a good person trying to shed some layers of insanity that has come over me over this past year and reconnect to who I really am and to what I really want and to my connection to Hashem, which exists within me and is always dear and is always at the essence of who I am.